Hi everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DPC Technology, and I've got a fun one today. Today, we're gonna do a UNVR instant kit install for somebody that has no other Unify gear. You may have seen my UNVR instant review a few months ago, and I'll link that down below. But Unify was nice enough to send out a UNVR instant kit for me to test, and I gave it to my brother-in-law. What's unique about his setup is he has no other Unify gear. He's got an IQ fiber modem router combo, and that's pretty much all he's got for his networking gear. But he wanted to add cameras to his house, but he didn't want to have to buy a bunch of gear. So I immediately thought of him for this kit, and I thought it would make a great video for somebody that was looking to jump into the Unify system with no previous equipment. So let's go over the UVR Instant kit. It's basically the UVR Instant, a 1 terabyte hard drive, and 4 G5 Ultra turrets. You may have seen my review of the G5 Instant turrets. I'll put a card on the screen and a link in the description, but they may be my favorite camera for price to performance. They're really good cameras. And for my brother-in-law, I had 2 extra cameras lying around. I had a G6 turret and I had a G6 bullet, and I thought they might work really well in his install, so we in fact used them. But in this video, I'm gonna assume that you have no Unify knowledge and that you've never installed an NVR before. So with that in mind, let's get started. And the first thing that I would do, if I didn't know exactly how I was gonna plan this out, is I would jump in the Unify Design Center. So I'm gonna jump into it real quick. It's at design.ui.com, and I'll leave a link down in the description to that. And you can see here, I've already imported an image of Craig's house. But if I did not already have that, you could go up here and go create new, and I'll go ahead and just do that really quickly. And you can choose whatever kind of installation you're gonna do. I'm just gonna go office, and I'm gonna go camera system. And that's fine, I'm just gonna keep the defaults there, and I'm gonna create new project. Now, I'm not gonna do that because I already have one, but that would bring you basically to here. Once you're in here, you're gonna have an option to import an image or design. I just went ahead and flew the drone up and took an overhead shot of the house. So from there, the first thing I did is I usually calibrate. And I already knew the garage door here. The garage doors in America are about 16 feet. And so I just kind of drew this, and it doesn't have to be accurate here. I just drew that and said that's 16 feet. And that gives me scale so that when I put the cameras in, it's going to show me what distance they're going to cover. And from there, all I did was under place device, if you click on place device down here, you can choose everything that's in Unify's ecosystem. So I went under cameras and security, and I drug out G5 Ultras. Where are your G5 Ultras? I just drug out a bunch of G5 Ultras. And you can just drag them and put them wherever you want to. And when you're done, you push escape and it will leave it. Now, if you actually didn't want that one there, you can click on it and I can click delete. So I already placed the 6 cameras and I placed them where they were. I also put the UVR Instant in here as well. Now, I could do some more stuff in here. I could draw lines to each one of these and see basic distances of how much cable I would need. But in this, I had 1 box cable. I knew I needed 1 box cable or less. And so I didn't really do too far down the rabbit hole because I just needed the basics. And I think that's probably for a first timer what you would need as well. I put the G6 turret in the front here because the G6 turret has the face and license plate recognition, and I wanted that in the driveway. The driveway is underneath this tree. Now you can see here there's a little blue dot out here in front of it, and I can click on that blue dot and then I can change the field of the swipe there. And just so you know, hey, where am I getting here? One of Craig's design needs here is he did not want to see in his neighbor's yards. So you can see once we get into the final installation, what we did to not be able to see on this one that's going down this side, not to be able to see in the neighbor's yard. But we placed them all, we kind of moved them around. This tree you'll see a little bit later was in the way, as well as some of these shrubs. We went ahead and cut back some of these shrubs, and we cheated this camera a little bit further down the way, which was something we could do in Design Center and see, okay, that's good. Another thing here in Design Center is we really realized we wanted 6 cameras. We started out with just the 4 and we're like, well, we probably need 2 more to get 100% coverage. If I turn on the cameras all at once here by clicking this little camera button, you can see here in their field of view that I've got all of the perimeter of the house covered. And if I, was missing something, like let's say I put this here, I would see it very easily that I'm missing some coverage there. It's really easy to do it in software rather than getting up in the attic and realizing you need something later that you didn't design in. So that's my first step. I really recommend doing this in Design Center just really quickly, especially if you haven't done one before, just to make sure your logic is good and where you have the cameras is appropriate. I'm also going to put a link to all the tools that we used here. We obviously used a bunch of basic tools like a ladder, a drill, a screwdriver, but addition to that, we use some of the spade bits. I'll put a link in the description. Electrical tape, RJ45 ends, a crimping tool, a wire stripper, some electrical tape. And I'll put a link to all of those things, as well as there's two other specialty tools that you may or may not use. There's something called fish sticks, which are these fiberglass sticks that you can put down a wall cavity, or fish tape, which is a metal or plastic tool that you can push down a wall cavity. I'll put links to those down in the description as well. Like I said, this was a pretty easy install. We were able just to walk through the attic. Obviously, getting over to the soffits took a little bit of crawling in the attic, but other than that, it was just some labor in this instance. Also, in the DMARC network box that we have there, we were able to pull down existing cables or tape and pull up existing cables so that we didn't have to fish down that wall. So this ended up being a relatively easy install. It took about a half day's worth of labor for two people to get it installed. I just wanted to give that information if you're coming from scratch, just give you a couple of those resources to get your project moving along. And so with that, I'll hand it over to Daniel and Craig, let them get started on the install, and I'll come back at the end and kind of wrap things up.
All right, today we're installing a NVR instant kit. We got four G5 turret ultras. That's all part of the kit, comes with the NVR as well, but we're also doing a G6 bullet. We're also gonna do a G6 turret. We're gonna do a whole setup start to finish for somebody who doesn't have any other Unify gear. All right, so this is where the NVR is gonna go. We're gonna do a little bit of cleanup work and pull up some of these old coax and zip tie this up top. But we've got our modem up top. I'm gonna run a line down that goes to our NVR in here, and then it'll go up through this little conduit here, and I'll run the rest of the lines to all the cameras. So it should be a clean install. The only thing that we might have to do is install a fan on here if it gets too hot, but we're gonna find out if it does or if it will run fine in here. So that's the plan. So this is the first location. We're gonna do the G6 turret here, right on the corner. And this will cover the whole front yard and the driveway, and it'll catch anybody's face if they're coming up to the house or anything like that. This is the second location. We're gonna do a G5 turret here, and this will catch anybody that comes up to the front door. This is under like the front patio area. And this is gonna be the first camera that comes in the instant kit. This is where it's gonna go. We're actually gonna put the bullet camera here, and it's gonna shoot across the side of the house here. Next location is right here on the corner. This is gonna be covering the backyard. We're gonna put another turret ultra here, G5. This will cover majority of the backyard. And then we're actually gonna do one more camera inside the patio up there, and it's gonna shoot this way and cover the towards the fence on this side. And then that will cover another area, portion of the backyard. So that's the plan. That should be all six cameras. All right, guys, so we've got all our lines ran now.
I'm gonna jump in real quick and go over the running the lines here. Obviously, it was pretty easy in this attic. We were able to drill with a spade bit right up into the soffit and pull lines back to an existing DMARC in this house. So for us, it was a pretty easy install. I'm gonna link to two videos here. One is gonna be the cable pulling video. It's a really popular video that Marty did a few years ago. It explains how to go up and down a wall. You may have to go through some wall cavities just depending on how your house or office was built. So I'll link to that video. That's pretty informative there. I'll also link to the video that we did about terminating cable ends. You're gonna have to put ends on this Cat 6 cable where they go into the camera. And it's pretty easy to do. So you can see that Craig has already drilled a hole with a 7/8 inch spade bit and then run the line through it. And now he's just drilling some guide holes so that it's easier for him to screw in the screws that came with the kit. I will mention that while in this install, it was very easy to mount these directly to the soffits. In many cases, you will need a junction box. And what that will do, if you're drilling into masonry or brick or something like that, it gives you a little bit of room between that surface and the camera itself to put the cable. And I'll leave a link down in the description below for those junction box. You can get them directly from Unify or any big box hardware store. Next, you can see that Craig is putting in the grommets that come with the kit. Again, in this install, they're going to be recessed up in the attic, and maybe this is a little bit of overkill, but in exterior installs where you're going to get exposure to moisture and the elements, you want to put this grommet kit around the Cat 6 cable and ensure that it is going to be weatherproof. It's really simple. You just put the little grommet in, you screw it together, and then you pop it in and screw it down. It's really pretty easy to do. And then Craig just pushes the excess up in the ceiling. And on the bullets, you'll see another trick here. Before you put the entire unit up, it sometimes helps to get the unit angled in the direction that you want to get it going towards. So in this instance, there's a pretty extreme angle leveling it up with the soffit. And you get it in that angle and then screw down that final little bit. There's a couple ways to do this. You can put the frame up there first and then screw the camera on it. But sometimes it makes more sense to do it this way, where you put it all together, get that angle right, and then just cinch it down to the base plate.
All right, so I'm a little dirty now, but we got our lines ran. I'm about to work on pulling them down here into the network closet. So I'm gonna tape all my cables to one of these old coax lines, and I'll have my guy who's helping me pull this up or push this up. And then once I get it up top, I'll tape my cables to it, and then we'll pull it down. And then once I get all my lines here, we'll terminate. We're gonna put the NVR unit in here, get it turned on, and then we'll go through the camera setup. We've got all of our lines ran, terminated, cameras, most of them are in place. So we're gonna switch to the NVR setup. So I'm just gonna put the drive in now. We mounted the back of this to the wall in there. I'll show you that in a second, but we're just gonna put the drive in real quick, and it's super simple. This piece comes up, slide it in. Drop that down. It's good to go. Drive's installed. Let's go set it up. Okay, so we got all of our lines ran here, and they're all terminated. We cleaned up the closet a little bit and moved some things out of the way, but we actually mounted the back of the NVR unit right here. So that way, this will just sit in and push down, and then we'll plug in all of our cables up here, and we actually have to run one more line up to the modem up top, just so this has internet. But other than that, we're about ready to do the NVR setup on Unify Protect and Network App. We are just patching in the cables now. We're gonna turn the NVR unit on in a second here. All right, let's give it some power. Okay. Let's see if we look down here. I don't know how well if you can show that little face on there, but it's booting up. It should start doing an update here in a minute normally. Oh, but I gotta connect it to the modem real quick. All right, we've got all our lines ran, did a little bit of cable management. I made one extra line for port 7. That's gonna run up to your internet source. It's just our modem here. And got the power done. We got it mounted to the wall again. And it does have an HDMI viewing port. If you would want to do that, you could connect it directly to a computer. So let's set it up now and adopt all the cameras.
All right, so Craig used his phone to do the install. He basically used two apps to do this. He used the Unify app. Using Bluetooth, the Unify app finds the UVR Instant, connects to it. He was then able to rename it to a common name. And once he did that, it asked him to set up a Unify account. So he set up that Unify account. Once he was done setting that up, he used the Protect app. And the Protect app is basically the camera control app to finish setting up the cameras. So basically, once he logged in the Protect app with his Unify account, it found all the cameras and let him install them. One thing of note is the G6 turret and the G6 bullet were used on a previous install, so we had to go up and manually reset those cameras, which basically is click the reset button on those, hold those down. That did a factory reset and let us reacquire those two cameras. So once Craig got that set up on his phone, we can now go to unify.ui.com, log in with those Unify credentials, and we can now see the cameras. And here you can see the final setup. It looks really beautiful. I will say we spent another hour or so going around and fine-tuning the angle of all the cameras so that they were perfect. One of Craig's criteria is he did not want to invade any of his neighbor's privacy. So you'll see here that we've kind of angled things down a little bit lower. We're not getting too much into the neighbor's yard. And we actually put a privacy area here along that long shot down the backside of his house. Another thing I will say is we used a G6 bullet here on the backside of his house. That probably was a little bit of an overkill. We probably could have done a G5 bullet instead. The G6 bullet is a little bit more expensive. What we were looking for was the throw and the narrow angle of view on the bullet. And we wanted to get all the way down the side of his house just to see if anybody would be walking down there. So we used the bullet. The G6 is a little bit more expensive. It has more AI detections than the G5 bullet. He probably is not going to use any AI detections in the side yard. He does have more detections on the G6 turret here in the front yard. Here you'll get license plate recognition and facial recognition, which is nice to have in this one camera. But overall, a really beautiful installation. And you can see how nice these G5 turret ultras are. What a value those cameras are. I continue to say they're probably one of the best values out there, especially in the Unify ecosystem. You can see the difference between the $129 G5 turret ultra and the G6 turret, which is $199, and also an incredible value too. Both have a really nice image, but you can see here how nice it is to be able to mix and match these cameras. One more thing here under camera capacity, we are still within the capacity of the UNVR Instant. So we are running 6 cameras here. We are coming towards the end of it though. You can also see here we've got 16 days of footage here, and we're probably 2/3 of the way through the capacity of the 1 terabyte hard drive. So for these 6 cameras, I think that's probably a perfect blend there. You obviously could replace that hard drive with a bigger hard drive in the future if you wanted to, but that's it. Now Craig's able to use his phone or a computer, or if he wanted to put a monitor somewhere and run an HDMI cable to it, the DisplayPort that's built into the NVR Instant as well, anywhere he wants to, with no other Unify gear. He doesn't have another Unify switch, another Unify router, another Unify access point. There's nothing. This was from the ground up. And for around $1,000 and a nice Saturday afternoon project worth of time, he's got a really high-end system here that he can view from anywhere in the world that's giving complete coverage of his yard at really high quality. I think the value of this UNVR Instant and the UNVR Instant Kit is pretty amazing. I'll put an overlay of the total cost of the system, but if you have any questions or comments, please put them down below. As always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.